Welcome back for Unit 2. I hope everyone's gaining confidence in the things you learned in Unit 1. We're going to continue to build on those in this unit as well as in the rest of the course. Our main goal for this unit is to make the web crawler, instead of just finding one link on a page, to find all of the links on a page so we could follow those links and collect more and more pages on the web. To do that, we need two big new concepts in computer science. The first is procedures. Procedures are a way to package code so we can reuse it more easily. The second is control. We need a way to be able to make decisions and do repetition to find all those links on the page. What we saw at the end of Unit 1 was a way to extract the first URL found on a web page. That's great. We could find the first target. But if we want to build a good crawler, well, we don't just care about the first one. We care about all of the links on the page. We need to extract all of those links, figure out where all of those links point to, so we'll find many more pages to crawl than just the first one. So that's the goal for this class as far as building the web browser. To do that, we're going to learn two really big ideas in computer science. The first is about procedures, and that's a way to package up code so we can use it in a much more useful way than we could before. And the second is about control, and control structures will give us a way to keep going to find all the links on a page. So let's remember the code we had at the end of Unit 1. We solved this problem of extracting the first URL from the page. We assumed the page was initialized to the contents of some web page. We initialized the variable start link to the result of invoking find on page, passing in the start of a link tag. Then we initialized the variable start quote to the result of finding in the page the first quote following that link tag. Then we initialized the variable end quote to the result of invoking find on page to find the first quote following the start quote. And then we assigned to the variable URL, extracting from the page from the character after the start quote to the character just before the end quote. We could print out that URL. And this worked to find the first URL on the page. If we wanted to find the second one, well, we could do it all again. We could say, well, now we want to advance, so we're only looking at the rest of the page. So we could do that by updating the variable page, assigning to it the result of the rest of the page starting from end quote. And remember, when there's a blank after the colon, that means select from this position to the very end. And then we could do all the same stuff. So we'll do start link again. We'll do start quote again. So now we've got code that's going to print out the first URL, keep going, updating the variable page, and then doing the exact same thing, printing out the second URL. If we wanted to print out the first three, well, we could do it again. So now we've got code to print out the first three URLs on the page. Let's scroll all the way up. So we got print out the first one, keep going, print out the second one, keep going. So this can go on forever. So the reason we have computers is to save humans from doing lots of tedious work. We don't want to make humans do lots of tedious work. Certainly typing this out over and over again would be really tedious. And it wouldn't really even work that well. We have pages with hundreds of links, but there are other pages with only one or two links. So it wouldn't make sense to copy this hundreds of times. There's always going to be some web page that has more links than we have copies of it. And any page that has fewer copies, we're going to run into problems because we're not going to be finding any of those links. So our goal today is to solve all of those problems.